Welcome to our Pocket Recital for the Bedford Park Festival 2020. I'm going to sing six songs for you today. The first four are by Gabriel Fauré, the fifth is by Ronaldo Hahn, and the sixth is by Francis Poulenc. I'll be giving short introductions to each song as we go along, and I do hope you enjoy it. My opening song is Au bord de l'eau by Gabriel Fauré. Fauré wrote this song near the beginning of his career in 1875. At the time, he was living a very stressful life in Paris. He was holding down three jobs and had a young family. And he used to love to go and sit by water to de-stress. His favorite holiday was to go to the Swiss mountains and sit by the lakes there. So this song is about a couple sitting by water and letting the water just sort of take away all their worries and cares. It's a very zen sort of song. At the end of it, the poem says that the greatest thing is love. Everything else can just flow away. Au bord de l'eau.
Ce soir, tous deux au bord du feu qui passe, me voir passer, tous deux si glissant dans l'espace, me voir glisser à l'horizon s'il fait un toit de chaume, me voir fumer.
My second song is Les Berceaux, which means The Cradles, also written by Fauré at about the same time, 1878, as Au bord de l'eau. The words of this song are about a seafaring community, and the opening of the song describes the huge ships tied up on the quay on a sunny summer's day. It then looks at the people in the community, both those who work aboard the ships and those who are left ashore, being the women and children, and that they say their goodbyes to each other and then each have their separate roles to play. As the song goes on, you feel the huge menacing power of the sea. And in the last verse, you can feel the huge ships start to move out, and they are somehow checked by the power of the souls of those who are in the cradles ashore.
Prenez par garde au berceau.
My next song is Mandoline, written in 1891. The words describe a group of friends meeting in a park or a very large garden underneath the swaying tree, the gallant musicians, and there are the beautiful women who have come to listen to them. The song then gives a list of all the people that are there and a quick description of all of them, which is sometimes quite sarcastic. Clitandre comes in for a bad review, as apparently she's a bit of a bore. Damis is the one who is very outspoken but writes beautiful poetry. And there they all are in the dusk, dancing in the gardens and listening to beautiful music. Mandoline. My fourth song is Les Roses d'Ispahan. This is also about a garden, but it's a very exotic one, full of orange blossom, jasmine, and the most beautiful roses, not to mention singing birds. The writer talks about how the garden is not as beautiful as his lovely Layla, and she has the most beautiful lips. Her voice is very light, like running water. But she has gone, all the kisses have fled from her lips. However, the author is also optimistic. He hopes that she will one day return, that the young love, like a butterfly, will come back to the garden. And then once more the orange blossom will be fragrant, once more the roses will bloom, and it will be as fragrant and wonderful as it was before.
Tu rire léger, sous les mille colovies.
My next song is Reverie by Rinaldo Hahn. It was written in 1888. Rinaldo Hahn was a contemporary of Fauré's, but he was born in Venezuela, although he spent most of his life in Paris. In Paris, he went to the conservatoire at the age of 10. And this song was the first that he wrote at the age of 14. It's a very happy little song. The main idea behind the words is that here on earth, every soul gives someone something else. And then as it develops this idea, I give you at this hour the finest things I have in me. Please accept my thoughts, however they come to you. Please accept the flame and shade of all my days and the caresses of my songs.
Esqueci pas tout amour, ton à quelqu'un, sa musique, sa flamme, ou son parfum. Esqueci toutes choses, ton toujours, son épine, sa rose, à ses amours. Rasalera la donne l'oiseau que le balai pavanche ton embouton, puisque lorsqu'il arrive si reposé la demeure à la rive ton nom baiser.
My final song is Les Chemins de l'Amour by Francis Poulenc. It was written in 1940 when he was in Paris, and I think there are some interesting parallels between then and now. In 1940, Paris was occupied by the Nazis and everyone was having to live their lives in secret behind closed doors. In 2020, we are occupied by coronavirus, and we are also largely having to live our lives between closed doors, but that is not stopping us. So the words talk about the pathways to love, the ways of remembering the things that we love and cherish. And it's worth remembering them because they were so good that even if it comes to a point where life is gradually being forgotten. The singer wants to remember the one day when she remembers being on a walk and feeling her lover's hands on her for the first time. Les chemins de l'amour. Thank you for listening, and we hope you enjoyed our recital, which came to you from 3 South Parade in Bedford Park.